So to fill the moulds with dark chocolate, you want to make sure that your mould is not really, really cold. So you can either leave it on top of your tank to warm up, or you can use a hairdryer or a heat gun just to go over the top, just to make sure that it's not really, really cold and just at kind of room temperature. So next, you're going to take your tempered dark chocolate. You want to cut off the end of the piping bag, make sure that goes into the bin. Then you want to pipe into every single hole as quickly as possible. So once you've filled every single hole, you can then tap it onto the table. See the air bubbles coming up and popping. Take your tank, have another little tap around the edges. With the handle of the scraper, never use the metal side. Be careful of your fingers. Okay, then what you can do is turn the mould upside down, tap it, let the chocolate drop out. Just going to turn the mould around. So try and keep this over the tank best as possible. Then you're just going to hold it and you're going to swipe underneath to take off the excess drips. Okay. And then again, just swipe over the top just to take off any excess chocolate from the mould. You want to take off all of the chocolate from around the edges, because that will interfere with the backing off process if you leave it on. Okay, and then you just want to let it set and then add your filling. Okay. That will set very quickly. So to fill your mould with your ganache, you want to make sure your ganache is not hotter than the shell temperature, so no hotter than 30 degrees for this one. You want it kind of fluid still so it can kind of flow nicely into the moulds. So just put your tip in and just fill up the hole. Remember, you don't want to go above the mould, so just get down and look at it, make sure it's not poking up above. So you want as much filling as possible, but you don't want to overfill it because that will cause problems when you're putting the backs onto the pies. Always have your tip inside of the mould. Don't try and let it fall in like this, okay? Otherwise it will be very, very difficult for you to judge how much you're putting in and it will be messy. So just make sure it's into the bottom of the mould and then drag it along. Depending on the shape, if you had a round one you'd just squeeze it and not move it, because this one's rectangular, I'm kind of moving it along as I fill it up. Let that set and then you can back it off. So it will take around sort of 5 minutes to set in the fridge. So to back off your pralines, what you need is tempered dark chocolate. You're going to cut the end off. Just be careful where that ends up, just put it into the bin. Then we're going to pipe over half of the tray. We pipe about halfway. And what we're going to do is just gently just bring the chocolate back to cover the rest of the holes. give it a little tap. Oops. Just a little tap. Just so it can fall into place. And we're just going to push really, really hard across the back of the mould just to reveal each little praline. Don't go over it more than twice, otherwise you'll get a rough finish. So twice maximum. Then clean around the edges with the excess chocolate. And then you can pop that into the chocolate fridge to crystallise and then demould 20 minutes later. So once your pralines have had at least 20 minutes in the fridge to set, you can just twist the sides of the mould, you'll hear a slight crack, turn the mould over and they should just drop out.